Welcome to this program. In November 2024, it will be a new election in the United States, and it will be decided if it shall be a president for the Democrats or a president for the Republican Party. And now we shall go through a plan for the Republican not directly party, but supporters of the Republican Party. And that is mandate for leadership, the conservative promise, Project 2025, presidential transition project. And before we go into this document, this plan, we will have a prayer together. Dear Heavenly Father, we have seen from the Bible that the United States will play a special part in this last struggle on this earth. And when it shall be a new election in the United States, we know that it can go both directions, either to the left or to the right. So, but we have seen this movement that is started now to uplift the Republican president for the new election. We pray that you must help us to understand this plan so we better can understand the time which we are living. We pray for this in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, you have seen the text. Mandate for leadership, the conservative promise, Project 2025. And then this is a plan. We will soon see, it's a big document that supporters of the Republican Party, they have made a plan for the president, and will support him if he will work for this plan. And therefore they have made a promise to America. The Heritage Foundation has played a part of this project. It was in early 1979 that Heritage launched the Mandate for Leadership project. They brought together hundreds of conservative scholars and academics across the conservative movement. And then we shall look a little more on this conservative promise, and many of them are Christians. This book is the product of more than 400 scholars and policy experts from across the conservative movement and around the country. They do not agree in all things, but they have put the differences behind their back, and now they have promised to work together for this plan in order to save America from economic ruin and moral ruin. I have written the text like this because my English is not good, so then you perhaps better can understand what I'm saying when you can at least read the text. And then this Project 2025 is a 920 pages document that details how the next Republican administration will implement radical and sweeping changes to the entirety of government. This blueprint assumes that the next president will be able to rule by authority, fiat, under the unitary executive theory, which means that the president has the power to control the entire federal executive branch. It is also based on the premise that the next president will implement Schedule F, which allows the president to fire any federal employee who has policy-making authority and replace them with a presidential appointee who is not voted on in the Senate. In this way, the next administration will fill its ranks with political appointees. And then we take the next page here. With replacing federal employees with like-minded officials, Trump-era conservatives are planning to remove federal employees whom they perceive as obstacles to the president's agenda early on. This would avoid the pitfalls of Trump's first year in office and eliminate the possibility of any resistance a public Republican president would encounter. And Project 2025 will give more power to the president, nearly 100% power to the president, in order to fulfill their plans for America. So this is heavy stuff. And then on page 13 we read, "We want you." The 2025 presidential transition project is the conservative movement's unified effort to be ready for the next conservative administration to govern at 12 o'clock noon, January 20, 2025. So this is a plan by the grassroots movement, by religious and secular authorities, to increase the presidential power from January 20, 2025. And the plan is that the president immediately shall start the process to make the planned changes within the first 180 days of his presidency. They think this is the last opportunity for the next president to save the republic. And we know that the United States, they are in a very difficult situation as a nation, because they have so much debt. I think they have about nearly $35 trillion in debt. And now this new speaker in the House of the Republican Party, Mike Johnson, he's saying to have all this system to run, we have to have $1.5 trillion more from renting from the bank, money from the bank. And this is only for 6 months. And then he said that after 6 months, we will have at least $1.5 trillion more. So the debt will soon be $40 trillion in the United States. And then also the people, they have perhaps, between 15 and 20, perhaps closer to $20 trillion in debt. So together it will soon be between $50 and $60 trillion in debt. And it is interesting in this plan that they want to finish abortion. They do not agree to with these lesbian and homosexuals. They will stop them. And it is very radical movements they are doing. And it is also interesting to look on this page here. Okay, I shall turn this paper and then we can see. So we have gone through this. Did I forget to turn the paper?
No.
Or
no. We have not gone through
this. We have not. No. They say that it is not 1980. No, we are in 2023, and the game has changed. the long march of cultural Marxism through our institutions has come to pass. The pendulum is going from right to left and back to the right-wing group. They want a radical change because they say that the nation is on a rim to destruction, and they want to use this opportunity to implement their radical change. They will take care of the ordinary family life. They are calling for ending abortion, as I mentioned, and the LGBTQ movement. Pornography should be outlawed, they say, and the people who produce and distribute it should be imprisoned. Educators and public librarians who purvey it should be classed as registered sex offenders. And telecommunications and technology firms that facilitate its spread should be shuttered. Ah, it's a very clear conclusion here. And what I wanted to emphasize here in a special way, this is on page 589, about in the middle of this product, of this plan, they have a headline, Sabbath Rest. And when I read this, I wondered, why are they dealing with the Sabbath rest? That is about religion. But they have this in the middle of this page 589. You can read it yourself. We write, they have written it like this. God ordained the Sabbath day, Sabbath as a day of rest, and until very recently, the Judeo-Christian tradition sought to honor that mandate by moral and legal regulation of work on that day. Moreover, a shared day off makes it possible for families and communities to enjoy time off together rather than as atomized individuals, and provides a healthier cadence of life for everyone. Unfortunately, that communal day of rest has eroded under the pressure of consumerism and secularism, especially for low-income workers. And then they say here, Congress should encourage communal rest by amending the Fair Labor Standard Act to require that workers be paid time and a half for hours worked on the Sabbath. And then they say that day would default to Sunday. Except for employers with a sincere religious observance of a Sabbath at a different time, example Friday sundown to Saturday sundown, the obligation would transfer to that period instead. It is interesting that they mention also this. It is an exception in a way that people that have Sabbath rest as you have it in the Bible, they can be an exception. But it was nearly the same as when the first Sunday law came in 321 year after Christ. It was Constantine, Emperor Constantine, that established this law, this Sunday law. You know, they celebrated this in March 2021, 1,700 years after Constantine established this Sunday law. And then it was also some people, they kept Sabbath, the biblical Sabbath, Saturday, from sunset Friday to sunset Saturday. And some people then started to have the sun day, the day of the sun day. And it was both. But soon it was a persecution of the people that wanted to continue to have Sabbath as a day of rest, the biblical Sabbath. So, you know, this exception here will only endure a short time. And then we know by from the Bible it will be Sunday that will be the day of rest for all people by law. And then in this connection we have this question. Why are they asking for a shared day off and to enjoy time off together and to have a communal day of rest? Which day is that? Yes, they are planning, plainly saying that day is Sunday. And Congress should encourage communal rest. This is not in harmony. This is not in harmony with the Constitution in the United States of America, which says that the Congress shall make, shall not make any law about religion. But no, they will try again, as I did in 1888, to establish Sunday as a day of rest. Because in 1888, it was a movement backed up by the trade unions to establish a Sunday as a day of rest in the United States of America. And I shall make another video about this. Because this this proposal was not accepted in the Congress at that time, but now it is a movement again to establish Sunday as a day of rest. And in the last days I have seen on internet that they also tried to point to the blue laws that already are in many states in the United States that required Sunday as a day of rest. And then we have this document from the Pope. It's called the Laudato Si, and paragraph 237. We read, Sunday, like the Jewish Sabbath, is meant to be a day which heals our relationship with God, with ourselves, with others, and with the world. So it is interesting also that that we also now have the Green Sabbath movement. That is also a movement. The United Nations, the Vatican and the world leaders are working for a Green Sabbath, which is Sunday. They say that there is hardly any cost to keep a Green Sabbath once a week. This will cut carbon emissions. It is a solution that will have a profound impact on climate change for a little to no capital investment. Once a week can result in a 15% annual emission reduction per country. So the solution to the climate crisis for them is Sunday as a day of rest. And to continue here, for them, then, the Green Sabbath is Sunday. For them, the Green Day is Sunday. For them, the Green Statue is Sunday. And when we shall try to understand this, we can we read in Daniel chapter 2. That all the people should worship the statue of gold. They should bow to the green statue. And or they should bow to the golden statue. But now they want to bow to the green statue that is Sunday. And then, you know, this is not only in this movement is not only in America, it is also in Europe, especially perhaps in Europe. And then we shall have some facts here that the Catholic bishops in the European Union will have Sunday as a day of rest for all people in Europe. And two, the European Sunday Alliance will have Sunday as a day of rest for all the people in Europe. And even fashion and beauty magazines promote Sunday as a special day of rest, the day of families, and the day when stores are closed. And Oliver Roting, the leader of the European Trade Union, UNI, is saying, Sunday should be a day of rest for all in Europe. So then the trade unions will help to establish Sunday as a day of rest in Europe and in the whole world. And in this connection, it is very interesting that Ellen White, she wrote something also about the trade unions. The trade unions will be one of the agencies that will bring upon this earth a time of trouble such as has not been since the world began. So the trade unions will help to establish Sunday as a day of rest in Europe and in the whole world. This is very interesting. And then I will say a little about this Mike Johnson. And you can forget this because I will say something more about this Mike Johnson. It is interesting to note that the new Republican U.S. House Speaker in America is Mike Johnson. He was elected on October 25, 2023. He is working for binding church and state together, just as former President Donald Trump. Mike Johnson is saying that it is no text in the Constitution that will separate church and state. So he wants church and state to work together. And Mike Johnson is a Christian, and many Christian leaders are saying that Mike Johnson is a man who has a deep rudder of faith and understand that our nation must return to founding principles. Interesting. And in the Bible, we read in Revelation chapter 13 about the image of the beast and the mark of the beast. It is a second beast, the United States of America, which will introduce the image of the beast, church and state together. USA has been a country where church and state has been separated. But Donald Trump, as I understood, took away the barrier between church and state. And many political leaders in the United States are saying that the separation between church and state does not exist anymore. As we already have seen, Mike Johnson also says that it is nothing in the Constitution that hinder that church and state can work together. So now the church more actively work together with the state in the United States of America. And in this book, The Great Controversy, page 445, we also read this. The image of the beast, where do we have this? The image to the beast represents that form of apostate Protestantism which will be developed when the Protestant churches shall seek the aid of the civil power for the enforcement of their dogmas. So church and state in the United States of America, they will work together. The barrier between church and state will be taken away. I think Donald Trump did that in his presidency. And now the next step is to introduce the mark of the beast. Now they more openly are working with this topic in many countries, also in Project 2025, and as we have seen, also in Europe. When the Mark of the Beast will be introduced in the United States or America, we do not know. We do not know when they will do it, but according to the Bible, they will start this movement. But they are working with this topic now, and suddenly it will be here. It is church and state that will introduce the mark of the beast. And then we have this text here from in the Bible, from Revelation chapter 13, verse 16. He that is talking about the second beast, the United States of America, we can read this in verse 11. Caused all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and slave, to receive a mark on their right hand or on their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. So this was from Revelation 13, 16. And I must say that we, in our mission, we have lost our bank account. The bank took our bank account. So we do not have any bank account now. We have also tried in another bank, but they say that if the main bank, central bank, has decided that you have taken away your bank account, we cannot give you any bank account either. So, when you not have a bank account, it will be like this. It will be a digital centralized system worldwide. And then you cannot buy and sell if you not have a bank account. And it will be like this in the last part of the world history. The people that not will accept and the mark of the beast, they will be punished so they not can buy and sell. And then they can... The authorities, they can just take away, the bank authorities and the state together, they can take away your bank account, and then it is a difficult time. President Joe Biden. Well, I have some small text here, but you can forget this. Because I will say a little more about this. But President Joe Biden, he is a Democrat. And he is a Catholic. And it was recently, he talked about that he will support the trade unions. And this was very interesting to watch. And we have seen that... The trade unions, they are very powerful institutions in the world. And they will work together with the movement that will uplift Sunday as a day of rest. And Joe Biden is in favor of this, to support the trade unions. And we know that, as I already have said, the trade union also supported this movement to uplift Sunday as a day of rest in the United States in 1888. And it is also interesting, as we have seen here in this project, that Project 2025, they also here are talking about Sabbath rest, and that day is Sunday. And this is, so now we can see that both Joe Biden from the Democratic Party, he will support the trade unions that also is working for Sunday as a day of rest. And then we have also the Republican Party now in this Project 2025. They are also talking about Sabbath rest, that is Sunday for them. And now in that way you can see that both the Democrats and the Republicans, they are in favor to lift up Sunday as a day of rest in the United States of America. And the Supreme Court in the United States, They are saying that Sunday as a day of rest is not against the constitution. So in that way, they can establish Sunday as a day of rest, and this is not against the constitution. And then I think we shall turn the paper here now. And then we shall read this quote from The Great Controversy, page 591 to 592. And this book here, it was written for about 120 years ago. It was Ellen Goldwhite that wrote this, that God really revealed for her what would happen in the world, last part of this world history. Then we read like this. While Satan seeks to destroy those who honor God's law, he will cause them to be accused as lawbreakers, as people who are dishonoring God and bringing judgment upon the world. Those who honor the Bible Sabbath will be denounced as enemies of law and order, as breaking down the moral restraints of society, causing anarchy and corruption, and calling down the judgments of God upon the earth. Their conscientious scruples will be pronounced obstinacy, stubbornness, and contempt of authority. They will be accused of disaffection toward the government. Ministers who deny the obligation of the divine law will present from the pulpit the duty of yielding obedience to the civil authorities as ordained of God. So it will be hard to keep the biblical Sabbath from sunset Friday to sunset Saturday. And we continue in this quote. In legislative halls and courts of justice, commandment keepers will be misrepresented and condemned. A false coloring will be given to their words. The worst construction will be put upon their motives. As the Protestant churches reject the clear scriptural arguments in defense of God's law, they will long to silence those whose faith they cannot overthrow by the Bible. Though they blind their own eyes to the fact, they are now adopting a curse which will lead to the persecution of those who consciously refuse to do what the rest of the Christians' world are doing, and acknowledge the claims of the papal Sabbath. The dignitaries of church and state will unite to bribe, persuade, or compel all classes to honor the Sunday. The lack of divine authority will be supplied by oppressive enactments. Political corruption is destroying love of justice and regard for truth. And even in free America, rulers and legislators, in order to secure public favor, will yield to the popular demand for a law enforcing Sunday observance. Liberty of conscience, which has cost so great a sacrifice, will no longer be respected. In the soon coming conflict, we shall see exemplified the prophet's word. The dragon was wroth with the woman and went to make war with the remnant of her seed, which keep the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. And this is from Revelation chapter 12, verse 17. And then I will say something about this, because we read in this quote that even in free America, rulers and legislators, in order to secure public favor, will yield to the popular demand for a law enforcing Sunday observance. The demand to have Sunday as a day of rest will come from rulers and legislators. Now it is coming from rulers and legislators in the United States of America in Project 2025. And Donald Trump, Mike Johnson, and many other Republican leaders are mostly in favor of this project, Project 2025. And then we shall read a quote here from the book The Great Controversy, page 445. When the leading churches of the United States uniting upon such points of doctrine as are held by them in common, shall influence the state to enforce their decrees and to sustain their institutions, then Protestant America will have formed an image of the Roman hierarchy, and the infliction of civil penalties upon dissenters will inevitably result. And in this connection, it is very interesting that in 2008, the biggest churches were gathered together in the United States, and they agreed upon 10 points. And point number 7 was to have Sunday as a national day of rest in the United States. And these church leaders, they sent these 10 points to the Congress, asked them to accept this plan. And then we read in Revelation chapter 13, verse 15, that and he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. It is interesting here that Ellen White is writing here that penalties will be given to dissenters that not will accept the mark of the beast Sunday as a mark of Sunday as a day of rest. And in this quote here from Revelation 13:15, we read that both, that is church and state, the image of the beast, they will cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. So the Bible is telling us that this will be very hard times for the people that will be loyal to God. And we are not some rebellious people that are working against the government. But even though if the government is not in harmony with the Bible, we read in the Bible that we shall be loyal to God more than to the authorities on this world. Yes, then we read here from a book called Testimonies for the Church. Volume 6, page 18. This was written in 1900 by Ellen Glaude White. Then we read, as America, the land of religious liberty, shall unite with the papacy in forcing the conscience and compelling men to honor the false Sabbath, the people of every country on the globe will be led to follow her example. And then later on, she wrote this, foreign nations will follow the example of the United States, though she leads out, yet the same crisis will come upon our people in all parts of the world. So, this Sunday as a day of rest by law will start in the United States, and then all the people on the earth will follow this strategy. And then we have this quote here also from Ellen White. The substitution of the law of men for the law of God. The exaltation by merely human authority. Of Sunday in place of the Bible Sabbath is the last act in the drama. When this substitution becomes universal, God will reveal himself, he will arise in his majesty and shake terrible the earth. And it is therefore this we are waiting for now. This is the last act in the drama. When they will introduce Sunday as a day of rest, because this is against God's law, where we read that it shall be the Sabbath. God introduced the Sabbath as a day of rest from the creation. He created in 6 days and rested on the seventh day, and he blessed the day and he made it holy for all people. Some people, they are saying that the Sabbath is just for the Jews, but it's a failure, because the Sabbath was introduced from the beginning, a long time before the first Jew came, by Abraham. And so, therefore, the Sabbath was made for men. And then we read in from this book, Great Controversies, page 615, and this is the 1911 edition. As the Sabbath has become the special point of controversy throughout Christendom, and religious and secular authorities have combined to enforce the observance of the Sunday, the persistent refusal of a small minority to yield to the popular demand will make them objects of universal execration. And as the decree issued by the various rulers of Christendom against commandment keepers shall withdraw the protection of government and abandon them to those who desire their destruction, the people of God will flee from the cities and villages and associate together in companies, dwelling in the most desolate and solitary places. And then we are soon finished now, only some few quotes more. The agencies of evil are combining their forces and consolidating. They are strengthening for the last great crisis. Great changes are soon to take place in the world, and the final movements will be rapid ones. And in connection with this, that the final movements will be rapid ones, then we have this text also from Romans chapter 9, verse 28. For he, talking about God, will finish the work and cut it short in righteousness. Because a short work will the Lord make upon the earth. So, these two texts here, they link together. It will the last movements will be rapid ones, and the Lord will finish the work and cut it short in righteousness, because a short work will the Lord make upon the earth. So we are living now in a time where things are happening very fast, and suddenly this movement will be upon us. They are working with this now. I know that some people are saying that it is no Sunday laws in the pipeline. But it is Sunday laws in the pipeline now. They are working with this. And soon it will be a reality. Ja. Skal vi se. Det her. Det gikk helt galt nå på slutten.
You are speaking Norwegian now?
Yes, no, it was an accident. But I will hold it here, because now I will give you an appeal about country life. living on the country. I will appeal to you to come out from the cities, because it will be very difficult to live in the cities. It will be short of food, little food, and it will be so regulated and controlled in the cities that it will be even difficult to come out from the cities. And I will ask you, if you understand this situation, how we are living now, how many of you have thought about this, to move out from the cities to the countryside? In the Bible, we read about Lot. God said to him, you must come out from the cities, because it will be rain of fire over Sodom and Gomorrah, the cities. And Lot, he lingered, and his family, they lingered. And at last the angels took him in the arm and took him out of the cities. And then all the people in the city, they were destroyed by this fire. And soon, we have seen, very soon, it will come very difficult times. And it will be a benefit to follow God's guidelines now, so we can come out of the situation in the best way. Pray to God for the right time to leave the cities, and He will answer you. Actually, the counsel has already been given to come out from the cities. And if you linger as Lot did, then it can be very difficult for you. Now is the time to act and to find a place on the countryside, so you can grow your own vegetables and you can live peacefully as long as possible on the countryside. And then in this time, we also have a message to give to the people, the three angels' message, as we find it in Revelation, the last book in the Bible, chapter 14. Read these verses from verse 6 to 12, and also from Revelation 18, verse 4. These three messages has to be given to the world. And if you want to read these messages more carefully, and if you will help to give out this message, then go to our webpage, endtime.net, and then you can read the little pamphlet, The Struggle Behind the Scenes. This is about the three angels' messages that shall be given to the world before Christ will come back again. And then I just have to lift up this here and read this quote. Though no man know the day nor the hour of his coming, we are instructed and required to know when it is near. We are further taught that to disregard his warning and refuse or neglect to know when his advent is near will be as fatal for us as it was for those who lived in the days of Noah, not to know when the flood was coming. And we will end with this. And we will end with a prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for the guidelines from the Bible, and also from Ellen White, that was in harmony with the Bible. I pray that you must help us to be prepared, prepare ourselves for the last great crisis that will come upon God's people. That we must learn to work with you and to stay together with you, because we need your protection. And then we also pray that as many as possible can help to give out this three angels' message that will be a test for people to if they will follow you or if they will follow the world. We pray for this in Jesus' name. Amen.